Unit 5, Prose, A Question of Space by Neera Kashyap. Introduction. This lesson demonstrates how self-observation leads to self-improvement and change in attitude. Despite maintaining a consistent rhythm, Vikrant found himself completely out of breath at the end of the 3.2 kilometer jog, his head pounded with the effort and with thoughts of the pressure his parents were mounting on him to gear up for the medical entrance test, still a year and a half away. Both successful doctors, themselves his parents, were anxious that Vikrant ready himself to cope up with the intensely competitive environment that had to be scaled for getting admission to a prestigious medical college. Class 11th had started with his mother's constant harping on the importance of the year for getting a good grip on science and maths. For viewing this as a foundation year for class 12th and for using this as a practice year for launching into the 12th board and medical entrance exams, his father quizzed him constantly on maths, physics, biology, till his head spun. The conflicts had acquired a distinct edge ever since he had met Anuj, who had spun into his life like a new universe right here on this jogging track. Anuj was not just a person with dynamic ideas on photography, on the connectedness between human beings and all other living species, on self-improvement as a part of human evolution. On the cosmos, he had turned into a friend very quickly, a much older friend, while reading a book borrowed from Anuj and experimenting with Anuj's old Kodak camera. Vikrant knew that his parents had watched his new interest with growing dismay. His class grades had dropped. He had started skipping group tuitions, only even the extra school classes designed for the weekends. An only child, as tension grew up between Vikrant and his parents, so did his identity with Anuj. Panting, Vikrant flopped on a concrete bench just beyond which Anuj was exercising on the metal swing bars grouted into the earth. Nothing like a good workout under the blue sky, much better than air-conditioned gym, said Anuj, with satisfaction leaping off the bars to drop onto the bald grass. Hey, what's up? You look grim. Vikrant shrugged and there was silence. Then he asked, did your parents put pressure on you to become a photojournalist? Oh no, laughed Anuj. I started on my own with journalism and then took up photography much later to make the stories alive visually. Then after a pause, he said, is the pressure at home bad? Vikrant tried to shrug but nodded instead. It seems to be that the pressure is worse for children of doctors, perhaps because medicine is considered the noblest of professions and gives prestige. But tell me, how do you react to pressure? Oh, I explain, I argue, I snap, sometimes I even walk out. It is worse when I lose control. Yay, but have you noticed how your body reacts? My body? It? No, not really. If you want to get control over a situation, you could start by first observing your body's reaction, your posture, body temperature, muscle contractions, breathing, the taste in your mouth. How will that help? Asked Vikrant, doubtably. It will help you witness your reactions as if they were happening to someone else. By observing your body and its reactions, you also distance yourself from them. This distance will help you first see, then control your reactions, said Anuj. Then, why not you observe your body when you are feeling happy or excited or adventurous? Why only you are under pressure? Quizzed Vikrant. Sure, why not? Actually, our range of expression is quite limited. If we get familiar with our full range, we will become aware of all our habitual expressions. But the next step is to aware of all our habitual expressions. But the next step is to practice expressions when there are no feelings to be expressed. I know this sounds daft, but think, if you can express emotions without expressing them, said Anuj. Like how? Asked Vikrant. Okay, suppose you get news that you have won a free trip to the US, how would you react? Urged Anuj. The US? Wow! Exclaimed Vikrant, giving to his hands, body and face such an exaggerated expression of glee that both collapsed laughing. Self-observation happened on its own much sooner than Vikrant expected. At dinner that night, his father asked, Vikrant, have you found out which is the most suitable coaching center for your medical entrance tests? No, said Vikrant. No? What do you mean, no? If you still have not found out, when do you intend to enroll? I don't know. I'm already full up with tuitions, bio, maths, physics, chemistry. It is tough. I cannot do tuitions. Vikrant noticed that his mouth was dry, his head tight at the temples, his body slightly hunched. Tuitions for medical entrances are not just tuitions. They coach you for a career, for a highly competitive exam. One wrong answer could make all the difference. It would be better if you turned your attention to investigating a coaching center rather than spend time with junkies and irrelevant things, finished with Vikrant's father. Vikrant noticed that his father's last remark sent a strong wave of heat through his otherwise weary body, galvanizing him to leave the room without another word. Vikrant knew these conflicts were not getting him anywhere. It was not as if he felt medicine was all wrong for him. He just did not want to be bulldozed like this. Bulldozed into working 3 shifts a day, 6 days a week, he felt he needed time to pursue his own interests and pleasures, especially after his meeting with Anuj. Anuj spoke to him on various issues of the beginnings of life, the places he traveled to, the elements he used to compose a photograph, self-observation. If you can express yourself without feeling, you can feel as well without expressing, he had said. When alone, Vikrant tried to practice emotions he had not experienced. At first, these were a joy, spontaneity, excitement. When he felt more neutral, he practiced a wider range, suspicion, hostility, daring, joy, scorn, each with its accompanying posture and gestures. His experiments with self-observation helped him see a whole range of his body reactions, the effect that different emotions had on that body, and how the mind got involved with these. But things did not seem to change with his parents, who, he realized, would continue treating him like a child. So as long as he just chafed and reacted, don't worry too much about the change, advised Anuj. Nothing, Vikrant's discouragement one evening. You cannot really change anything till things are all ready for change. Just do your part. Yeah, but it does not help, said Vikrant with dejection. Anuj thought for a long while, then he spoke. If you really want to get control over a situation, there are 2 more steps for your practice. The moment an active feeling comes which you think should be controlled, make a note of it, but don't express it. What is the last step? Asked Vikrant, almost mechanically. The last one is difficult, replied Anuj. This step involves expressing an emotion opposite what you feel and can be done only if you are agitated. You observe this but choose to express calm or warmth instead of coldness. As simple as that, laughed Vikrant a little hopelessly. Vikrant kept up his exercises in self-observation, practicing emotions he did not feel. Even attempting not to express feelings that came up hot and strong, he felt small stirrings of change. He could see things more objectively, even when he could not control his reactions. His parents were pushing less, listening more. He noticed that instead of both of them speaking in one voice at points of control or friction, one spoke while the other refrained. This was leading to much more interaction, except on the subject of Anuj. Are you still hobnobbing with that character? What is his name? Asked his mother at breakfast one morning. His father's silence was expectant. Vikrant observed his temples tighten, his hunched shoulders straighten out in confrontation. His pulse became irregular. His name is Anuj. Mummy, he replied, Anuj Jain. Anuj is a friend. In fact, more, he teaches from him. I have learned many things, things that are hard to explain. Yes, but he will not be sitting for your entrance tests, will he? If you lose your grip on class 11th, you will never catch up in class 12th, said his mother assertively. As Vikrant felt his temples throb, a sudden calm entered his heart. If I am allowed space for new interests, I will also find space for what is important for a career, he said quietly. This time it was his father who spoke, fine, try to achieve a balance, we will be with you. At the end of class 11th, Vikrant enrolled for classes at a coaching center for medical entrance tests. He did this with an awareness that it was the right thing for him to do.